Hello everyone, this is Dr. Mitesh Gala. Welcome to Roughbook, a learning companion.
Hi, in this video, we are getting into solution of right triangles, exercise 24. There is only one exercise in the entire topic. I'm breaking it into two parts. So we are going to hit part one. Now this topic is relatively simple if you know the previous two chapters on trigonometry. But if you're doing this direct, it's going to be tough because you're expected to know both the properties of both the chapters. So you remember the first topic, Osha Chota, we did? Osha Chota, in which S was sine, cos and tan, opposite hypotenuse, opposite adjacent. So you just have to remember sine, opposite upon hypotenuse, cos, adjacent upon hypotenuse, and tan, opposite upon adjacent. These three only are required, the other three you don't require. And you also require the value of the table. You remember the table values? 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90, the standard angles. Sine, cos, tan, cot, sec and cosec. So sine 0 was 0, this was half, 1 by root 2, root 3 by 2 and 1. We used 1, 2, 3, 4 divided by 4 and then the square root, perfect. This one will come here, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, half and 0. Tan is dividing these two, so 0, 2 goes on top, cancels, so what you get is 1 by root 3. This is 1, this is root 3 and this is infinite. Likewise, infinite, root 3, 1, 1 by root 3 and 0. Sec is opposite of cos. So 2 by root 3, root 2, 2 and infinite. Likewise, infinite, 2, root 2, 2 by root 3 and 1. Once you know these two things, now the topic will become very simple. Last thing that you need to know is value of root 3. 1.732. and root 2, 1.414. These two values you are expected to know on your own. So when you're doing the sums and you get a root 3 from somewhere here or root 2, you're expected to substitute the values and then solve the sum, okay? So let's hit it. Sum number 1, part 1. So they've given you a triangle, right angle triangle obviously. And this is 20, this is 60 degrees, this is x. Your target is to find x. So the first thing you need to do is name it. Your target is to find BC, that is X. So look at the angle that is given. What are the components related to this? So opposite and hypotenuse. So opposite upon hypotenuse is sine. Very good. So you will say sine 60 is equal to AC upon BC. Substitute all the values and gradually you will understand how to go about it. Pause the video, try it on your own. Even if you get it wrong, no problem. Come back, I will help you. So sine 60, we know the value is root 3 upon 2, AC is 20 and BC is X. So X goes on top, you get 40 by root 3. You can't leave this in root 3, so you have to go to chapter number 1, rationalize the denominator. So into root 3 by root 3, so X will be 40 root 3 by 3. So that will be 40 root 3. Come on, I just taught you the value, 1.732 divided by 3. So when you multiply, you'll get 4 2s are 8, 1 0, 4 3s are 12, 28 and 1 29, 4 5 6. So 69.28 divided by 3. So 3 2s are 3 3s are 3 0s are 9s are and then 3 3. So you can write 23.09. Behind they've converted to one decimal, so they've written 23.1. Don't bother about this. Two decimal places you leave and you will get it correct. So your final answer therefore X 23.09. So if you carefully focus on one sum, you will realize that you are using sine opposite upon hypotenuse Osha Chota. You are using the value of sine root 3 by 2. And third thing, you are expected to know the value of root 3, that is 1.732, plus the rationalizing part. So each sum in this chapter will require three things. Number one, Osha Chota. Number 2, standard values, and number 3, root 3 and root 2 ka values. So you are expected to know all that. In case if you've taken this lightly, please right now I request all of you all, memorize this or practice this or take a screenshot of this and put it on your screen or your softboard. So when you're doing the next sum onwards, it becomes easy for you to grasp. Otherwise, it's going to be very difficult. If you have not known this and you're trying this chapter, it's not going to be possible. So better get this first, go step by step, and gradually it will become very smooth for you. So one part three, come on, let's hit this one. So first thing, name it ABC, 20, 45 and X. So with respect to 45, opposite upon hypotenuse. So again sine. So come on, pause the video, try it, 100% you will get it. So sine 45 equals to AB upon AC. So sine 45 is how much? 1 by root 2, AB is 20 and AC is X. So X becomes 20 root 2. So root 2 ka value 1.414. So X will be 2 4s are 8, 2 8 2. And decimal. So final answer 28.28 meters, centimeters, anything given? Nothing given. So write units. There you go. Got everyone how to go about it now? So if you know the first basics which I taught you, you will rock this chapter. So let's take the next one. Two part one. Come on your own. You don't need my help at all. In here, they have given you the sides. They are expecting you to find the angles. You have to go reverse, okay? So name ABC. With respect to A, this is adjacent upon hypotenuse. Adjacent upon hypotenuse, cos. So cos angle A, adjacent is AC, hypotenuse is BC. So cos angle A, we don't know. AC is 10 and BC is 20. So half. But cos, how much is half? Look at the table and give me the answer. How much cos is half? Yes, cos 30, no, 60 is half. Therefore, angle A becomes 60. See, this is also half cos. So, A ke jagah pe what will come is 60. Are you getting it? How to get this one? Likewise, this two part 3. Can you try that one? 100% you will manage. First thing, give a name. Now, A is already there. So, you should avoid taking A. So, let's take BCD. Now, from the point of view of A, opposite and adjacent. So, opposite upon adjacent, tan. Perfect. So tan angle A, opposite is BC, adjacent is BC. So how much is tan angle A? We don't know. So keeping it as it is. This is 10 root 3 and this is 10. Cancels. So tan angle A is root 3 upon 1 means root 3. But tan something is root 3. How much? Tan 60. And therefore you can say that A is equal to 60 degrees again. How many managed to get this? Put a hands up. Brilliant, you're doing a good job. Let's take the next one, sum number 3. 3 is slightly different but not difficult. So A, B, C, D. CD is 30, your target is to find X. So obviously since this is known to you, so first triangle, which one are you going to hit? A, C, D. Yeah, take that triangle, use tan 60 maybe and get AC. Once you get AC, now that is for this triangle, now you can use X opposite upon hypotenuse and then find the value of X probably. So first find AC. So step one, get into this triangle, opposite upon hypotenuse, adjacent, so use tan, get here. And then use X ka opposite upon hypotenuse, so sine. Come on, pause the video, try it on your own. So number one in triangle ACD, I am saying tan 60. Is opposite CD upon adjacent AC. So tan 60 is root 3, CD is 30 AC. So AC becomes 30 upon root 3. Rationalize it. So you will get 30 root 3 by 3 cancels. So 10 root 3. Keep it as 10 root 3. Okay. Don't get this into decimals right now. Always convert it to decimals only when it is the final step. Otherwise, don't do it. Okay. So 10 root 3 we got AC. Now we're getting into the other triangle, triangle ACB, and we will say tan X. X is this, opposite is AC, upon hypotenuse is AB. Now opposite upon hypotenuse is not tan, it is sine. So sine X, AC we just got 10 root 3 and AB is 20. So what do I get? Sine X is equal to root 3 upon 2, but sine how much is root 3 upon 2? Yeah. Root 3 upon 2 is sine 60, and therefore I can easily now say that X is equal to 60 degrees. So we are using a connection here. Are you able to understand? First you use this triangle, found AC, then we use that AC for this triangle and found X. That's how we are getting into it. Isn't it amazing? Yeah, if you know the basics, this is going to be one of your favorite chapters. And this chapter is very important from the point of view of 10th standard, also from the point of view of life, because it helps you to calculate the heights and distances. Heights and distances is the name of the topic in standard 10, one full chapter based on the same logic. So if you got this right now, you're half done for that topic for standard 10. Okay, let's come back. Your target is AD. Now, you know this triangle ka angle as 60 and this triangle ka side as 100. But you need in one triangle angle as well as side to proceed. So can we find this angle first? How? So if you remember, there is a property in standard 8, remote interior angle theorem, which says if this is your triangle, then the exterior angle is equal to sum of remote interior angles. That means these two angles ka total is this. So I can say this plus this is equal to this. And now this is isosceles, so both are equal, so I can call both of them as x and x, and I can find each of the angles, right? So first let's find this angle. For that I will say angle CAB is equal to angle CBA is equal to x. Reason will be AC equals to BC. So we wrote both of them as x, and now in triangle ACB I will say x plus x is equal to angle ACB. Reason will be remote interior angle theorem. So 2x is equal to 60 and therefore x is equal to 30. So therefore I can say angle ABC or ABD is equal to 30 degrees, this one. Now using this 30 and 100 for the big triangle ADB, I can directly get AD, isn't it? So I will say in triangle ABD, opposite upon hypotenuse, so that means sine 30 is equal to opposite AD, hypotenuse AB. At least now pause the video and try on your own, come on. So sine 30, how much? Half. AD, we don't know, and AB 100. So cross multiply and I will get AD as 50 meters. That's what your target is. They asked you to find AD and we found it. So do you understand the connection? From here you got this and from here you would understand the whole triangle. Sums are not tough. They are logical. They are helping you build your logic in life. And when your logic is built in life, you can crack anything in mathematics as well as life. Sum number 5. Fifth one, this is 45 degrees smaller angle. Bigger is 60 degree and this is 40 centimeter. Your target is to find AD. Now to get AD, how are you going to go about it? Pause, think and then come back. I will help you. Okay, you will take triangle DBC. Okay, you know tan 40, you know 45, 40. So you can use opposite upon adjacent, that is tan, and get DC. Then take full angle 60 and get AC using tan, because you know the base in that triangle also. And then AC minus DC will give you AD. So basically what we are doing is we are splitting this in two triangles. One is DBC, in which base is 40. Second is ABC, in which base is still 40. But here the angle is 45, here the angle is 60. This gives you DC, this gives you AC. And then from AC minus DC, what you definitely get is AD straight away, right? So come on, let's hit it. Number one, we will take this triangle DBC. So in triangle DBC, all right? I'm saying tan 45 is equal to opposite upon adjacent. So tan 45 is 1, DC is unknown and BC is 40. So therefore I can say DC is equal to 40 centimeters. So I got one part. Now get AC and then we will subtract both. So now this time in triangle ABC, always mention which triangle are you working at, okay? So in triangle ABC, this time also tan, but 60 is equal to AC upon BC. So tan 60 is root 3 by 2, AC is unknown and BC is 40. So 1s are 20s are, so AC becomes 20 root 3. So AC can be 20, 1.414. So AC becomes 4 2s are 8, 282, so 28.28 centimeters. This is my AC, but that's not my target. My target is AD. So I'll say therefore AD is equal to 40 -28.28. So whatever the difference now I get is going to be my AD. Okay. I think I messed up something somewhere. Yeah, because how can DC be smaller than AC? Not possible, no? So we messed up something for sure. Tan 60, AC upon BC. Tan 60 is root 3 by 2, AC upon BC. BC is 40, perfect. So 20 cancels, so 20 into root 3. It gives you this, that's also correct. But how can AC be smaller than DC? Not possible. AC has to be bigger than DC, obviously. So we messed up something somewhere. So let's recap the entire sum. Tan 45, DC upon BC. Perfect. Tan 45 is 1. This value is wrong. This is root 3 only. So this is going to be 40. So it's going to be 40 root 3. Correct? So 40 into 1.732. I'll have to multiply now. Sorry. See, I picked up the value incorrect. I'm not editing it, keeping it out over there. So you come to know how I am doing mistakes. You should not repeat the same mistakes. 4 2s are 8. 4 3s are 12. 29. 4 5 6. So 69.28. So finally, I'll get 69.28 minus 40. Am I correct? Let me check again. 4 2s are 8. 4 3s are 12. 28 and 129, 456, correct. So the difference should be 29.28 centimeters. So final answer, therefore, AD 29.28 centimeters. Got this? Was it interesting? Yeah. I was just about to mess up the question. Luckily, we found our mistake and we saved our time. Perfect. Let's go with the next one. Sum number 6. I'm trying to do maximum sums over here because I know these are all different sums. You might find it difficult, so I'm helping you out doing maximum sums here itself. They say ABCD is a rhombus and this angle is 60 degree. Let's say the diagonals bisect at O. Now there is a property of rhombus for the diagonals. What is it? Diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angles. Superb. If you got the same thing in your mind, perfect. This is 90 plus they bisect. So these parts are all equal. So if you know OB, you can get BD by making it twice. If you know OC, double it and you will get AC. So getting OA and OB is your target right now. So if you just look at this triangle, because trigonometry is possible only in right angle triangle. So AOB is a right angle triangle. This is full is 60, so half will be 30. That's another property. And then using that 30, opposite upon hypotenuse, adjacent upon hypotenuse. So sine and cos, when you use these two, you will get OB and OA, which you can double then to get BD and BC. Okay. So before that, therefore angle OAB will be half of 60. You don't need to mention anything, directly write this as 30, no problem. So now you're just working on this triangle, the most important one, OAB, with this 60 and this 30. So opposite upon adjacent, so we are using sine. So in triangle OAB, I will say sine 30, opposite is OB, adjacent is AB. So sine 30 is how much? Half, OB we don't know, and AB is 60. So therefore I will get OB as 30. Once I get OB as 30 centimeters, I can get BD straight away, double of OB. That's the property we already mentioned here, so no need to mention. So double of 30, and therefore BD becomes 60 centimeters. So you manage to get the first diagonal. Can you get the second one using cos? Come on, now at least pause, try on your own and then come back. Don't copy, don't be cheaters, okay? So cos 30, same triangle, so I'm not mentioning it again. Cos is adjacent, that is OA, upon hypotenuse AB. So what is cos 30? Cos 30 is half, no, root 3 by 2 is equal to OA, which we don't know, upon AB 60. So 1s are 30s are, so OA becomes 30 into 1.732. So OA, 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9, 3 7s are 21, 3 1s are 3, 4, 5. So 51.96, because 0 and 1 decimal, so I have put only 2 decimals, right? Centimeters. Therefore, AC is going to be double of OA. So that will be double of 51.96. So 6 2s are 12, 18 and 1 19, 2 and 1 3 and 10 centimeters. So you managed to get the value of AC also. Very important question from exam point of view. Please put a star besides it. Don't copy this. Try this again if you've copied and get it sorted nicely. Okay. Next one. Sum number 7. Again, this is an important question from exam point of view. Put a star besides it right now. Your target is to find entire AB. So you can break this into parts. What parts? Perfect. AC, CD and BD. How will you get AC? Think, come back. Then we'll talk about CD and BD. Got it? Okay. So you're going to use tan 45 opposite upon adjacent and get AC. Easy? How will you get BD? Perfect. Tan 60 opposite upon adjacent. So BD. How will you get CD? Wait. First get AC and BD. Then we'll come back and talk about CD. So gradually we'll be able to take it into chunks. And in the end we will add everything. Okay. So first one for AC. Pause. Get it. Come on. So in triangle FCA, tan 45, opposite is FC, adjacent is AC. So tan 45 is 1, 20 upon AC. So therefore AC is equal to 20. So we got AC. Sorted? So this is got. Now BD. So come on, in triangle FDB, I will say tan 60. Is equal to opposite ED, adjacent BD. So tan 60 is root 3. Last time I took root 3 upon 2, you remember, in that sum. This is 30 upon BD. So BD will be 30 upon root 3. Rationalizing it. So therefore BD will be 30 root 3 by 3. So finally I can say therefore BD is equal to 10 root 3. So therefore BD 10 into 1.732, so BD becomes 17.32. So we got this also. Now the last part, how to get CD. So come back and I can help you with CD. So I'm just drawing the partition over here. How will we get CD now? Any clue? Okay. So what you're going to do is, see 60, we cannot apply trigonometry because there is no right angle triangle. So we create one by drawing this and naming this as some random alphabet, let's say P. If you look at triangle FPE, alright, this is 60. FP, if I get, it will be equal to CD because it's a rectangle over here right now. So I am sorted. Now how to get FP? For that I need at least EF or EP, one of the two sides. Can I get EP? Pause, think, come back. EP. This is 20, this full is 30. So if 20, so EP will then become 10. Got it? So you can directly say over here, EP is equal to 30 minus 20, 10. We don't need to mention any reasons. It's understood that it's a rectangle. Okay? So we got EP as 10 and now jump into triangle EPF and say tan 60, opposite is EP, adjacent, sorry, opposite is FP, not EP. Upon adjacent EP. So tan 60 again root 3. PF we don't know, we are trying to find, and EF is 10. So PF becomes 10 root 3. 10 into 1.732, 17.32 again. And now if I add everything, I will get my AB. So AB is 20, 17.32 plus 17.32. So therefore AB becomes 3454.64 units because there is nothing mentioned as meters or centimeters, so write units. If you want, after this PF that you got, write one more step. PF is equal to CD 17.32. That one step you can add just to conclude that both of these are equal. And if your teacher insists, then you can prove that the triangle is a rectangle. Otherwise, I don't think so. It's really, really required. Got this? Good question, isn't it? Let's go to the next one. 8 part 1. 8 part 1 is even more interesting. It's a trapezium with 20, 20, 20 and 60. Your target is to find AB as well as the height. So let's first create the height. So DM the height. Now how will I get DM? How will I get AB? So for DM, I can take triangle DMA, sine 60, opposite upon hypotenuse, and I can get DM, that is the height. Wow, so height is simple, we got it, but AB is still a question mark. Let's get the height, come back, and then we'll talk about AB. So number one, in triangle DMA, I will say tan 60, opposite is DM, adjacent is AM. So tan 60 is root 3, DM unknown, and AM, I messed up. I had to take sine 60, opposite upon hypotenuse, that is AD, right? So sine 60 is root 3 by 2, DM is unknown, and AD is 20. So 2 ones are 10s are. So your DM will become 10 root 3, 1.732. So DM becomes 17.32 centimeters. So we got the height. Yeah. Now the question is how to get AB. Using the same triangle, I can find AM at least. So let's find that much. Whatever you know, that much you should start picking up. At least one mark you will get into your pocket. And then think about what you don't know. Gradually you will build, okay? So same triangle, so no need to write the name. And this time we are using adjacent upon hypotenuse, that is cos. So cos 60, adjacent AM, and hypotenuse AD. So cos 60 is half, AM we don't know, but AD is 20. So therefore I will get AM as 10. This is sorted, 10 AM. Now how to get the remaining MB? Directly not possible. So let's create one more triangle here. If this is 90, all right? And now this is an isosceles trapezium because opposite sides are parallel and these sides are equal. So this angle will be equal to this. So this is 60, 20, 60, 20. Automatically your NB also will be 10. So what you need to write to get this 10? So you will say quadrilateral ABCD is an isosceles trapezium. Isosceles spelling very important, I-S-O-S-C-E-L-E-S, okay, it's an isosceles trapezium, therefore angle DAM is equal to CBN is equal to 60, therefore BN is equal to 10. Directly you can write, mention over here, similarly as AM is equal to 10. So you managed to get both. How will you get MN? So this is 90, 90 and parallel. So obviously rectangle, so this also becomes 20. So you will say quadrilateral DMNC is a rectangle. You don't need to prove anything right now. And therefore DC is equal to MN is equal to 20. And finally, therefore AB is 10, 20, 10. And I can say AB is equal to 40 centimeters. Got it? Wasn't it? Oh yeah. So you got your height and you got your AB both. So in the end, mention therefore height. Mention that a height is equal to 17.32 centimeters. So we got the height and we got the base, that is AB as well. Last question. I'm breaking this into 10 questions right now. And second part, we'll do the remaining 10. Your target is to find AB. How will you get your AB? So you are going to break AB in two parts, AE and EB. This is 30, so this also will be 30, that is DE. Use this triangle, tan 45, get AE. Use this triangle, tan 60, get BE. Add the two, simple as that, isn't it? Pause, try on your own, come back. So first say that quadrilateral DC, BE is a rectangle. Since it is a rectangle, therefore BC equals to DE equals to 30 centimeters. So we got this 30. Now into the triangle first one, AED. I'm using tan 45, AE upon DE. Tan 45 is 1, AE is unknown and 30. So therefore I can say AE is 30 centimeters. So I got this 30. Now for BE. So in triangle BED, I will say tan 60 is equal to BE upon DE. So tan 60 is root 3, BE is unknown and DE is 30. So therefore I can say BE 30 into 1.732. Let's add it, sorry, multiply it. So 3 2s are 6, 9, 21, 3, 4, 5 and 0, so 1 decimal gone. So 51.96 centimeters is BE, correct? 51.96. So finally, therefore, AB is equal to 30 plus 51.96. So AB becomes 81.96 centimeters. Got it? Some number 10, that was 81.96. Perfect. How many of you all managed to get this? Yeah, that's amazing. If you are able to get this one, then next year in standard 10, 100% you will get your heights and distance easily. Okay, for your homework, I want you to do 1 part 2, 2 part 2, 4 part 1 and some number 9. Please do these sums honestly, don't cheat.
Hope you had a lovely mathematics experience with a Rough Book, our learning companion.